Hello, ladies and gentlemen. Today we're going to talk about trig applications and how these things are used in the real world. You're going to need something to write with, a calculator, and your notes. So, some uses of trigonometry. Trigonometry in ancient times was often used in the measurement of objects that could not otherwise be measured. So, in other words, how to find the distance between stars and Earth. So, today we're going to talk about a couple of real life applications and how we can use trig to help us solve. All right, so example number one, at a point on the ground 50 feet from the foot of a tree, the angle of elevation to the top of the tree is 53 degrees. We need to find the height of a tree. So again, we're still gonna set up, and like I said, we're gonna be using trig to help us solve this. Now we just gotta understand what this is telling us. So at a point on the ground 50 feet from the foot of the tree. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna draw a point on the ground and I'm gonna draw the distance to the foot of the tree. And we know from the problem given to us that this is gonna be 50 feet. The angle of elevation to the top of the tree is 53 degrees. So when we talk about angles for this, we're gonna talk about angle of elevation, which is what this problem is dealing with, but we're also going to have angles of depression. So, oops, if you want to jot this down, if we're talking about elevation, in our minds, hopefully we hear the word looking up. Since it's elevating, we're looking up. So then on the other hand, if we're angle of depression, this would be looking down. So if you just want to maybe find somewhere in your notes to write this down so you can refer to this as we talk about these, but angle of elevation means I'm looking up and an angle of depression means I'm looking down. So with that being said, in this example, we have an angle of elevation. So that means I'm looking up. So to the top of the tree, so I'm drawing the angle of elevation. So to the top of the tree, my angle of elevation is 53 degrees. Now we want to find the height of the tree. So if I were to draw this triangle, then drawing that last triangle, here's my right angle. I want to find the height of my tree. So looking here, I have an angle and I have one side. So here's where the trig is going to come in handy. So if I set up a problem, if this 53 is my reference angle, we have the opposite side and I have the adjacent side. So when I have opposite and adjacent, and SOHCAHTOA, opposite and adjacent would be tangent. So I'd write tan, my angle always goes inside that bubble, inside the parentheses, equals opposite of 53 would be x over adjacent, which is 50. So to solve this then, I'm gonna multiply both sides by 50. So I'm going to get x equals 50 tan of 53 because these 50s will cancel. So then I take out my calculator and I type that into my calculator exactly as I see it, 50 tan 53. And what do you get back? Hopefully your calculator is reading 66.3522. Now, since these are real life examples, we need to make sure that we put in that label. And since we're finding the height and it was in terms of feet, this is gonna be 66.352 feet. And this would be my final answer. So that's the first example of how trig is gonna help us in the real world or in a real world example. Let's try another. All right, in example two, in Washington, DC, the Washington Monument is 555 feet tall. So I'm gonna start by labeling that. 555 feet. If the angle of elevation from your line of sight is 75 degrees, so what I'm gonna do here is I'm gonna draw this person. The angle of elevation here to the top would be 75 degrees. We want to find how far away we are from the base of the Washington Monument. So this is my X, this is my unknown. Do we see the triangle here? If I draw this down, oh, sorry, that's not a very straight line. Draw this down. We want to find X here. So in parentheses, this is really important because our eyes, this person might be 5 feet tall. So your eyes would be 5 feet off the ground. So what I'm gonna do over here is I'm gonna take 5 feet off. So instead of being on the ground, we're looking from 5 feet in the air. So this is gonna be 550 feet. Okay, so now we're looking again. So if this is my reference angle, if 75 is my reference angle, we have the opposite side, which is 550 feet, and I'm trying to find the adjacent side. So again, opposite and adjacent uses tangent. My angle goes inside my bubble. Opposite would be 550 over adjacent, which is x. Now here, this solving gets a little bit difficult because now that x is in the bottom, we have to make sure that if I multiply by x on both sides, we're gonna end up just switching. Let me change my color here quick. All I'm gonna do is switch this x and the tan 55. So I'm gonna get x equals 550 over tangent of 75. Because my variable was in the bottom, my unknown was in the bottom, all I did was switch tangent of 75 and x. So now when I take this into my calculator, I'm gonna take 550 and divide it by tan 75. And when I do that, I get a number that should say 147.3721 if I'm rounding properly. And again, since this is a real world, we were started with a label, I gotta end with a label. So I would be, or you would be, 147.3721 feet from the base of the Washington Monument. All right, and example number three, you are standing 100 feet. So here's my person again, 100 feet from the Statue of Liberty. So this right here is gonna be 100 feet. Your eyes are 5 feet off the ground. Again, I have a 5 foot person, so 5 feet off the ground. And the Statue of Liberty is 305 feet tall. So she's 305 feet tall, but I'm 5 feet off the ground. I'm gonna subtract 5 feet again. I'm gonna be left with 300 feet. So the tip of her statue is 300 feet above where I am standing. So I'm gonna draw that in too. We need to find the angle of elevation. So now my x value is gonna be the angle. So I'm gonna make a new triangle here because we're 5 feet off the ground. This is 100 and the distance we're using is 300 feet. So now my angle is the unknown. So if I'm trying to find an angle, I hope you're thinking of using inverse trig. Up until the other two examples, we're using regular trig because we were trying to find a distance. But now that I'm trying to find an angle, we want to use inverse trig. So again, if this is my reference angle, we know opposite and we know the adjacent. So opposite and adjacent again would be tangent. The angle goes inside the parentheses or inside the bubble. Opposite would be 300, adjacent would be 100. Okay, now in order to get tan or that x out of the bubble, I gotta do the inverse operation, which would be tan inverse of both sides. So these two are gonna cancel out. X comes out of the parentheses, I'm left with tan inverse of 300 over 100. Then I type in my calculator, tan inverse 300 over 100, and you should get back 71.6 degrees if you round. So the angle of elevation when you're 100 feet from the Statue of Liberty from 5 feet off the ground would be 71.6 degrees. All right, in example number four, a 60-foot lighthouse sits on top of a 150-foot cliff. So if we were just to draw in this cliff, so this cliff would be 150 feet, but now we're talking about this lighthouse. Don't mind my poor drawings here. This lighthouse that is going to send out light, okay, this is 60 feet. So the angle of depression, now we're talking about depression. Depression means I'm looking down. So if I were to be looking down here, we got to think, okay, so if I was standing here and these were my eyes right here. These are my eyes. If I were to start by looking down, here is my regular line of sight. But if I'm looking down, then it's saying that this degree right here is 27 degrees because it's an angle of depression. So we have a boat that's sitting over here. Again, don't mind my poor drawings. This boat over here is saying that the angle of depression to this boat is 27 degrees. We want to find the distance from the boat to the base of the cliff. So we want to find the distance from the boat to the base of the cliff. This is my x value. So if I were to finish off this triangle, here's my right angle. So I have a right angle. But right now, this angle, this 27 degrees, is on the outside of my triangle. So how could I figure out what the inside value here, this green angle, is? How could I figure that out? Well, hopefully you're thinking that this right here would also be a right angle. So if I had to figure out this degree, I would take 90 and subtract 27 degrees. And when I do that, I get 63 degrees. So this inside angle would be 63 degrees. So remember, when I'm doing depression, here is my line of sight. When I'm looking down, this would be my angle. And this isn't part of the triangle that I'm dealing with, so I'd have to do a little bit of mental math before starting the problem. But now, if 63 was my reference angle inside the triangle, x would be opposite, and 150 plus 60, because we're on top of that, so this length then would be 210 feet in total. That would be my adjacent side, so again, we're going to use tangent. Now, in all four examples in today's video, we've used tangent, but I want to preface with the fact that tangent isn't always what we're using. It depends on what we're given in these examples. Sometimes we're given the hypotenuse and we'd have to use either sine or cosine. So it depends on what you're trying to find, making sure that you still set these up all according to how you would set up a trig problem. But anyways, getting back, tangent of 63 is opposite, which would be x, over adjacent, which is 210 total, because we're adding that lighthouse here to the cliff. So now if I'm solving this, I'm going to multiply both sides by 210. So I get x equals 210 tangent of 63. So I'm going to type that directly into my calculator exactly how I see it. And after I do that, you should get back 412.1482 feet. So that is how far the boat is from the cliff. So again, if you have any questions throughout this video, make sure you star that problem. Write down the question you might have so we can address that in class. I want to thank you for taking good notes, and I will see you in class.